Hello viewers, welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 4, the main team here. And yeah, at this point I'm just trying to crank my way to liberalism. This continent's nowhere near it, but the other continent has more civs and maybe further ahead in tech. Also, in the last segment, or maybe it was the one before that, we finally settled up all the cities we need on this map, so or all the cities I could get on this map anyway on Immortal. So, and now I'm just continuing towards liberalism. And there's just something I'd like to emphasize one more time. Other than the capital, which even there isn't very impressive in terms of its improvements, I mean, most of these cities have the likes of Granary, Hammam, Monument Library, and I only went the Hammam because it's both a happiness boost and a health boost, so it really allows me to grow. And then, yeah, all these cities are pretty low improvement, I mean, in terms of city improvements, but they have the tile improvements, and that's what's making the difference on this map. I'm going to go ahead and emphasize commerce everywhere. I'm not going to worry about universities yet. There'll be a bigger draw for me once I make it to democracy and start using emancipation girl cottages. Also, I think this city, I might leave the forests, I don't know. Yeah, once my workers are done clearing out the grassland forests, I think I'll switch my automated workers to leave the forests. In fact, I'll do that now. That way I can get some production using lumber mills or what have you. Same civics as before. Yeah, the tech rate's dragging a little, but it's not too bad, considering. I haven't even bothered counting up how many cities I have, but I'm sure it's not an immaterial value. Well, whatever, let's look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Yeah, I got up to 17 cities. Probably even beats out Gandhi. It does. It blows Liz out of the water. I don't know, she got up there. She settled an island chain or something, I don't know. Alright, well, I'm gonna automate workers in the interest of time now. Vast majority of the tile improvements I care about are done. And I'll go ahead and take nationalism. Thank God Gandhi didn't get the Sistine Chapel. His culture would be really annoying if that happened. Alright, well, as you can see, nationalism's the only decent value tech I'm getting from this. I didn't want to lose liberalism at random to, like, Pakal or some other random crappy AI on the other continent. I think printing press is the next goal here. I haven't been doing a lot of trades either. Do I have a lighthouse yet? Oh, I do. Yeah, I do have marble hooked up. So I'll just go ahead and put this in my bureaucracy capital. I really should do these trades, though. Here. You're not very good at this, so... Sorry, free religion. She has philosophy already. Okay. $200 a turn. Don't worry, viewers. The research rate will get a lot better once we get to democracy and can start building our improvements a little more rapidly. I mean, I could just be spamming units right now or something, and I'd get enough to compete with Gandhi and Elizabeth and even the warmongers, reasonably. It's not perfect. And you know what, I might just leave him backwards. He's probably pursuing culture, but he's doing a poor job of it. That way I can just roll him with cavalry. If I can, I'm going to want to showcase the Kremlin cash rush strategy in this game. I'm still running scientists here, right? Really? It runs more of them. Yeah, I've been in I just stayed in pacifism to get more great people points. It's not quite time to go free speech yet, and a lot of these are still, villages are weaker. And I'll get more for my capital. But that's gonna change soon. That's right, you guys rot while you're backwards. Ha ha ha. Can I get this next turn? I can. Be a material boost to my research straight away. We build a apostolic. The other continent. Yeah, look at that. Now I'm at 320, some beakers return instantly. Starting to get the money bags going. Sauce is weak, Gandhi. Weak sauce. Hopefully there's an engineer rush the Taj Mahal on me. I should sit on this. I'm not going to rely on them much anymore, and I could use them to bulb. I'm going to want to get communism, so I can use them to bulb scientific method or something. Or even astronomy. 9% Indian. Yeah, he's gotta go. He's annoying me. It's such a pissant way to approach the game, is trying to culture flip people. Culture victory in general is pretty bad, even though I know I did it in the last Let's Play I did. Oh, wow. Plus 215. Yes, sirree. Oh, if I could just make it. It's gonna be a little tight. To what extent am I relying on monarchy now? Not a whole lot. So I can do a temporary run at rep to try to crank my slider even more. Well, not crank my slider, but you know what I mean. Increase my research. Ultimately, I'll want to be using universal suffrage, but yeah. Someone trade me happiness? No. Okay. Jerks. Looks like I'll make it though. Barely. Then I can do emancipation. Harass the AI with emancipation rather than harassing me with it. Jerks. Okay, I guess in my cities that are getting pissy, I should be building temples. Well, let me make sure I make it first. Then I'll worry about that. 771 beakers. It's only going up, viewers. It's only going up. Let's see the big picture. Alright then. Actually, I don't think a forge would be a bad idea. Let's do forges. For happiness. Yeah, I was relying on that quite a bit, wasn't I? Well, I'm coming up on the time limit, viewers. I'm just going to build happiness buildings, let these cottages grow, hit the communism, and I will meet you next time.